So hello guys, the next question in this algorithm series is very big sum. So basically here they are passing an array and we have to return the sum of all elements in this array. So I think they have given the code of taking inputs. Yeah, they have written the code for taking inputs through file. This all complex code is about taking inputs from the files. So here they are taking inputs. The input is number of elements and these are the elements, respective elements. And in this, lastly we have to find the sum. As here they have seen, means these numbers are bigger. Now if you see in C language, there are data types and their range is fixed. So we have to check about the things, what type of data type we can use for the return and for storing the sum, like that. So here in this they have written the prototype of the function. If you see here, they are writing here return type is long. So we have to create a long type variable that can store our sum. So here they are passing this AR count, which is the count, which is the length of the array. And this is actual array, and this actual array is an array of long integers. So that's why here long star. So now we have to return the sum. Okay, after that we will see the code in Python, one liner code in Python. So first of all we will do this in C. So now I just wanted to iterate the loop and I have to add the elements. So first of all I will create a variable sum, okay, whose data type is long, because our expected sum is in long format. Okay, so I am creating here sum is equal to 0. Now I want to iterate the loop for int I is equal to, okay, so I is equal to 0, I is less than our length of array is AR count. So I is less than AR count I plus plus. Now in this loop I want to add my sum. Sum is equal to sum plus and AR of I. AR of I will get us the respective element in the array, and lastly we are going to return our sum, which is whose data type is long. So we are returning this as here they have given return type long, and lastly just we are returning the sum. So that is the basic thing, but they have to show about the things like these types. Means there are many test cases in this HackerRank. They just pass the things, means pass the limitations that we think. So for that, just they are saying that use these types of data types when you get an error, when your test case failed due to such types. So that was the thing about C. But in Python there is not any condition of data type or such things. So here in main they have taken all the inputs using like input.stream and they are passing the list to a very big sum function. Okay, so now we have to just return the sum of all elements. So we will directly return a function, a inbuilt function in Python. Okay, there is an inbuilt function sum in Python which directly returns the sum of all elements that we pass. Okay, now we are passing a list, then it will return the sum of all elements from that list. I am running the code again. Okay, so that was the thing. So, thank you guys.